I am Slick Nick, the living legend of hair loss. And now that I think about it, it's been exactly 1 week since I got this new, cool 39-year-old man hairstyle. Exactly a week. It was randomly on a Thursday. You all know the story. My son needed a haircut. I take him there. I like the hairstyle she gives my son. And I say, I'll take that hairstyle as well. And that's exactly what happened on a whim. It was never intended to happen, or maybe it was fate. So let's imagine I got a number one guard on the sides and the back. I left the top. She didn't take anything off the top. This is about 3 inches. And here we are a week later. And I will say, it's taken about a week to get to where I need to be as far as knowing how to style my hair. So it's funny because even looking at pictures from last weekend, I'm like, okay, I didn't quite know what I was doing yet. It still looks like a soggy beret on top of my head. But now I know. And of course, I filmed this one after my second speed run where I use a comb and mousse while I'm blow drying it. So I'll probably release this before I actually release the speed run. We'll see. Either way, both videos were filmed just minutes apart. So what I want to acknowledge a week later is, A, I've learned better how to style my hair, and I've proven I can do it in 54 seconds, less than a minute, which is just while it's still damp, I put in the mousse, I blow dry it while I comb it, combing the back forward and the front back into the side, and then I get a little bit of pomade on top and just kind of do it one more time, and that's where I'm at. So it's going to be interesting to see in the future how this grows out. I mean, with the number one, it's going to take several weeks before it even stops looking clean and nice and tidy. And I suppose, and typically when I know it's time to get a haircut is when my sideburns start getting bushy, they start getting curly. At that point, then I would go back to the number one. Something I am kind of kicking around, would I want to take any off the length on top? Instead of having 3 inches, would I want 2.5? Because about 5 years ago, I had a similar hairstyle like this. But looking back, what was different about it? It was blended on this side, and it was a little bit shorter on top, and it wasn't a number one, it was like a number three. So I did have that version of it, but ultimately I really like the number one. And the length, is, I think now that I know how to style it, is going to work for me. But I am kicking around the idea of, if I ever got tired of having this hairstyle, would I just keep the hairstyle but just make it shorter on top, where it'd be more of a spiky look instead of this? But I think as long as I know how to get the volume on here, it's going to be working. So here we are exactly a week later after I got this hairstyle on a whim, the pompadour undercut. And reminder, if you have questions, if you were going to go bald, do not ask me, do not reach out to me, do not try to be my friend. Don't leave a comment about it. Just watch the video. I made you an 8-minute video that will help you ask the correct 5 questions. And then what to do after you come to terms with that. That's the only conversation you need to have. That I'm not catering to people who are thinking the sky is falling and thinking that them being attractive is based on the looks. I address in the video, there's 10 things you're actually being judged for. It's time to man up and watch that video if you haven't. Comments are right here.